to this brief introduction to the Naval Surface Warfare Center Crane Division, known as NSWC Crane. NSWC Crane is best described as a Navy federal laboratory with a reputation for national technical leadership and a Navy lab that works directly with warfighters to create comprehensive, innovative solutions at the speed of relevance.
That describes the NSWC Crane of today. But the organization began as an ammunition depot over 75 years ago before becoming a premier Navy lab in the 21st century. To put things in context, let's start at the beginning. Imagine, it's late 1941 in the United States. The average cost of a new home is just over $4,000. A new car costs $850, and the Glenn Miller Band's hit song String of Pearls is playing on radios everywhere. War is escalating in Europe as Germany recently attacked the Soviet Union. In the Pacific, Japanese and U.S. tensions rise. The United States is preparing for the inevitability of a world war. U.S. defense officials have determined that there is a need for a place to store the nation's conventional ammunition located away from a coastline so that it is not vulnerable to a potential enemy attack. Property near what is now Crane, Indiana, originally planned as a state park, was chosen to locate the new Naval Ammunition Depot, Bern City. On December 1, 1941, the Naval Ammunition Depot, Bern City, was commissioned, and the timing was impeccable. Just 6 days later, on December 7, 1941, the attack on Pearl Harbor shook our nation. Since its creation, Crane has played a vital role in our nation's defense. The mission to store and ship nearly a third of the nation's conventional ammunition still resides at Crane and is now the mission of the Crane Army Ammunition Activity.
As for NSWC Crane, the organization has evolved from its roots in ammunition to become a high-tech powerhouse and a critical part of the Naval Research and Development Establishment. NSWC Crane has acquired a reputation for national technical leadership, and through a unique relationship with our nation's warfighters, NSWC Crane has become known for warfighter connectedness, and those in the local and regional areas surrounding the lab appreciate NSWC Crane for the organization's regional embrace through corporate citizenship.
National technical leadership, warfighter connectedness, corporate citizenship. NSWC Crane's technical work exemplifies these descriptors and is focused on three important missions, all vital to our nation's defense. These missions include expeditionary warfare, strategic missions, and electronic warfare.
When you think about the NSWC Crane mission in expeditionary warfare, think about our nation's elite warfighters, Navy SEALs and other special operators, and the capabilities they need to effectively operate in difficult circumstances. The nationally recognized scientists and engineers from NSWC Crane's expeditionary warfare mission work directly alongside these elite warfighters to innovate and solve tough, real-world problems to provide rapid response and proven solutions.
When it comes to NSWC Crane and strategic missions, picture a ballistic missile submarine almost 2 football fields long and the foundation of our nation's nuclear triad. The technical expertise and leadership from NSWC Crane's strategic missions has been essential to the operation of this submarine's strategic weapons system for over 60 years. And when you hear about a successful missile defense test, NSWC Crane's fingerprints are on key components that track and destroy enemy missiles. With strategic missions at NSWC Crane, the goal is to deter, defend, and defeat enemy aggression.
When you think about the NSWC Crane mission in electronic warfare, often referred to as simply EW, understand that EW involves using the electromagnetic spectrum to your advantage and denying access to your adversaries. If you have ever used a radar detector in your vehicle, you use the spectrum to your advantage. NSWC Crane is home to the largest collection of EW expertise and infrastructure within the Department of Defense, and the national technical leadership within the Crane EW mission is applied across the sea, air, land, and to an extent, even the undersea and space domains to control the spectrum so we can control the fight. These three technical mission areas work collectively to make NSWC Crane an indispensable technical force supporting our nation's warfighters.
In addition to the three technical missions, NSWC Crane maintains a robust set of business capabilities that are at the core of the organization, an organization that generates over $3 billion in annual economic activity. Business areas such as comptroller, contracting, and corporate operations provide business excellence to enable mission success at NSWC Crane.
The underlying strength of NSWC Crane and the real key to success is the dedicated workforce and the team-oriented culture that makes Crane an amazing place to work. The NSWC Crane workforce consists of over 5,000 government civilians and contractor partners, and nearly two-thirds are scientists, engineers, and technicians. The workforce is highly educated, with over 120 PhDs and counting, and over 650 master's degrees. NSWC Crane encourages employee growth through investments in employee education and advanced degrees.
NSWC Crane is intentional about nurturing and maintaining a supportive culture. Employee engagement is a priority, and trust, integrity, collaboration, and empowerment are all central to the NSWC Crane culture, a culture that embraces diversity and inclusion, such that all employees are welcomed and encouraged to make their voice heard. As an organization and as individual employees, NSWC Crane strives to be a good neighbor. The focus on corporate citizenship means that NSWC Crane employees are usually among the first to volunteer within the local schools and are known as community-minded, supportive citizens.
A more tangible way NSWC Crane corporate citizenship has played out has been through the development of a vibrant, nationally recognized innovation ecosystem across the region and state. Member organizations of this innovation ecosystem intentionally collaborate to create mission-critical solutions.
NSWC Crane is part of the technological backbone of the United States Navy, and while visiting, a previous Secretary of Defense was asked what he thought of NSWC Crane, and he said that when he thinks NSWC Crane, he thinks national treasure. So, what do you think when you hear NSWC Crane? Think NSWC Crane when you think about submarines and their guidance systems that have to work precisely, and we have to be assured that those systems have not been tampered with.
And when you think about ships on the ocean that need to be able to assess what is going on around them, to detect and protect from incoming missile threats, think about electronic warfare systems engineered at NSWC Crane. Think NSWC Crane when you think about the desert, the beach, and remote jungle areas, and the nation's warfighters, and the weapons, the ammo, the unique electro-optical and infrared systems they need to complete their specialized missions, and think about the solutions that come from NSWC Crane.
Think about Navy jets that take off and land from aircraft carriers in the middle of the ocean. And think about electronic warfare jamming pods and defensive flare systems that keep our men and women safe, and think NSWC Crane.
Think about space and hypersonic missile capability. Also, think about our strategic deterrent missile and consider the electronics that go into the missile and into the submarine that is used to launch that missile, and think NSWC Crane.
And finally, think about this. When warfighters need help solving their tough technical problems, they think NSWC Crane.